We know that the derivative will give us the slope of a curve at any x value that we ask, but sometimes we like to find the equation of the tangent line, not just the slope of the curve at a given x value, but the actual equation of the line tangent to the curve at that point. Now, if we think back to our algebra classes, there's two things that we need to find the equation of the line. One is obviously the slope of the line. And then the other thing that we need is some point on the line. Now, ideally, it would be best if we had the y-intercept at this particular point, but sometimes that's not always possible. But if we can find these two things, then we'll be able to achieve our goal of finding the equation of a tangent line. So this knowing those two things really simplifies our thought process. So just a quick reminder here, this is from your old algebra classes. You could either write a line in slope-intercept form. This is probably the most familiar form, y equals mx plus b, where the m stands for the slope and the b stands for the y-intercept. So if we were given both of those things, it'd be very easy to write the equation of those lines. Now, what happens more often than not, though, is the point that we're given is not necessarily a y-intercept, so we might be more inclined to use point-slope form in a lot of the situations. So again, you have to know the slope, but this format, y minus y1 equals m parentheses x minus x1, that's more general, or it allows you to plug in any xy point, not just one on the y-intercept. Okay, so let's try our first example. The first thing we need to realize or understand is that the slope that we're after can be found by differentiating the function. That's what the derivative tells us, is it tells us the slope of the curve at any x value that we ask of it. So if we're looking for that m, that's what the derivative is going to give to us. All right, so here we go. Find the tangent line to f of x at the point 0, 5. Now, this is kind of an easier example to begin with because I made sure that this extra point that's given, that is the y-intercept, 0, 5. X is 0, so the y would be 5. It would be a slightly more difficult if it was 2, 5 or 4, 5 or something like that. But anyways, let's look for our m first. So we'll differentiate the function. We get 3x squared minus 8x plus 3. And the 5 goes away because it's a constant. And the derivative, we'll recall, will give us the slope of f of x at a given x value. Now we want to know the slope at 0. Now it should just be noted, quick little side note here, when you're finding tangent lines or slopes of functions, only the x value is required. I won't go into a lot of detail, but it's due to the fact that the functions pass the vertical line test that you might remember from an algebra class, and every x value only has one y. So there's no sense or no need in providing the x and the y to denote the derivative. We only need the x. Now, if it wasn't a function, if it failed the vertical line test, then we would have what's known as implicit differentiation, and you would need both the x and the y, but that's another story. So here we want the slope at 0. And so we plug it in, we get 3. Now this 3 represents the m, or the slope of my tangent line at the given point right here. Now the point that we needed, remember back up here at the beginning, we needed the slope and a point. The point is given. The point is provided for us more often than not. So I've got both of these here and I'm ready to write my answer. So my final answer would be y equals mx plus b. Y equals mx plus b. So that would be the equation of the tangent line to this function at the given point right there. And we can double check our work by just verifying that the slope of my line is 3 as well as the curve is also 3. And when you plug in 0, you happen to get 5. So that point is also on the line as well. All right, so I went ahead and graphed this on the calculator. Here's y equals x cubed minus 4x squared plus 3x plus 5. And then sure enough, I graphed y equals 3x plus 5. Whoops, 3x plus 5. And sure enough, you do see that it is in fact tangent at the point 0 comma 5. So you can verify these, but just by graphing them and seeing if it really does come down and become tangent to the curve. Now, if you had graphed both of these and it was off the curve or away from the curve, I don't know if you can see that color, probably didn't show up that well, but if you can graph it and it's away from the curve, you must have done something incorrect because it does need to come down and lightly touch the curve at the point in question. All right, we're going to try one last one real quick. We're going to find the tangent line to y equals secant x at x equals pi over 4. So secant is a trig function and it's defined at pi over 4, and I want the equation of the tangent line at pi over 4. All right, so for that, first up, I'll take the derivative. And that this is not just a blindly taking the derivative. I understand what I'm doing it for, the reason I'm doing it is to find the slope of secant at pi over 4. So that's going to be my m for my upcoming tangent line. So derivative for secant, hopefully we know this, is secant x tangent x. Secant x tangent x. And so the slope at the point pi over 4, and in case you haven't seen this notation before, the way you can say evaluated dy dx at a given place is you can draw either a vertical line or a bracket, usually a vertical line, to the right of dy dx and just write x equals pi over 4. And that tells the reader that you're going to take the derivative and plug in pi over 4. Since it's not quite as conducive to plugging in points as like a f prime of x, this is much more natural. Dy dx doesn't really have a natural place to plug in values. So if you show that to your teacher, they'll probably be kind of impressed with that. But anyway, plug in pi over 4, and we get secant of pi over 4 times tan pi over 4. All right, now we need to know our unit circle a little bit here. Hopefully we're all fairly proficient at our unit circle. If you don't know the unit circle, make sure to download a completed unit circle and a blank unit circle from Google or something like that, and practice it, because you really need to know all the radian values and sine and cosine of each of those radian values on the unit circle. Make your life so much easier in Calc 1, 2, and 3. I do know that a lot of instructors just say, "Oh, don't worry about it. You don't have to memorize that. You can use this table during the test." But trust me, you'll wind up getting burned in later classes if you don't have the unit circle committed to memory. So here's the unit circle. Here's pi over 4 right here. And because I know the unit circle, you probably do too. Its x value is pi. Oh, sorry, that's the radian angle. The x value is root 2 over 2. And the y value is root 2 over 2. Okay, and that's at the angle pi over 4. So, tangent of pi over 4 being sine over cosine, the y value, as you probably know, is sine, and the x value, as you probably know, is the cosine of the angle. So, tangent is sine over cosine, those are the same, so that ratio would be 1. And secant is 1 over cosine, or in other words, the reciprocal of the cosine fraction. So root 2 over 2 is cosine, so 2 over root 2 is secant. Now that actually simplifies. If you do a little algebra, 2 to the first divided by 2 to the 1 half, subtract the exponents or rationalize the denominator, however you want to say it, you would get square root of 2 times 1, obviously. So that's the slope of secant at pi over 4 is root 2. So now what do we do to finish this off? Well, we just have a couple small things. I don't think, like the last example, I don't think y equals mx plus b would be most applicable here, because I wasn't given the slope and some specific point like the y-intercept. I was given the slope and some random point at pi over 4, which is not at the y-intercept. Okay, so I will need y minus y1 equals m parentheses x minus x1. Now, I don't have y1 right off the bat, so we have to go find it. All they told us was that x equals pi over 4. So for that, I would take that, plug it in secant. Now, coincidentally, I happen to have already done that in part of the derivative. Normally, we don't get that lucky, but I know that secant of pi over 4 was root 2. Okay, so that's just lucky for us. So our final answer, if we simplify that a little bit, we had y minus root 2 equals, I'm going to distribute that root 2 on the right-hand side, root 2x minus root 2 pi over 4. And then last step, I'll get the y by itself. Y equals root 2 x plus, I'll add this root 2 to the right, minus root 2 pi over 4. And believe it or not, that in a roundabout way wound up as y equals m, that was the slope, x plus, and it turns out all this here at the end was like your b, y equals mx plus b. That is a line. I didn't graph this one on the calculator, but you're welcome to. You may could get away with a decimal approximation of that or something like that. But as long as you know the theory or the concept of what you're trying to do, finding tangent lines is not that bad. It really just boils down to these two basic concepts: finding the slope that uses the derivative, and then the point that either they provide for you or somewhat provide for you, meaning they just give you the x and maybe you have to find the y that supplements it.